मैं यहाँ पर बात करें, जैसे कि इलेक्ट्रिकल मोटर्स की बात करते हैं, इलेक्ट्रिकल मोटर के सिलेबस में क्या दिया हुआ है, जैसे टाइप्स ऑफ मोटर, लॉसेज इन इंडक्शन मोटर, मोटर की एफिशिएंसी, फैक्टर अफेक्टिंग द मोटर परफॉर्मेंस, रीवाइंडिंग एंड मोटर रिप्लेसमेंट इश्यू, एनर्जी सेविंग अपॉर्चुनिटी विथ एनर्जी एफिशिएंट मोटर्स। तो सबसे पहले हम देखते हैं इंट्रोडक्शन में, मोटर कन्वर्ट इलेक्ट्रिकल एनर्जी इंटू मैकेनिकल एनर्जी बाई इंट्रैक्शन बिटवीन दी मैग्नेटिक फील्ड सेटअप इन दी स्टेटर एंड रोटर वाइंडिंग। इंडस्ट्रियल इलेक्ट्रिकल मोटर कैन बी ब्रॉडली क्लासिफाइड एज इंडक्शन मोटर, डीसी मोटर, डायरेक्ट करंट मोटर, सिंक्रोनस मोटर, दैट इज कॉल्ड आल्सो सिंक्रोनस मोटर। ऑल मोटर टाइप हैव द सेम फोर ऑपरेशन कंपोनेंट, वन इज स्टेटर, दैट इज स्टेटर वाइंडिंग, सेकंड इज रोटर, दैट इज रोटेटिंग वाइंडिंग, थर्ड इज वियरिंग एंड फोर्थ इज फ्रेम, दैट इज इनक्लोज्ड। देन वी कैन सी मोटर टाइप्स, फर्स्ट इज इंडक्शन मोटर। इंडक्शन मोटर आर मोस्ट कॉमनली यूज्ड प्राइम मूवर फॉर दी वेरियस इक्विपमेंट इन इंडस्ट्रियल एप्लीकेशन। इन इंडक्शन मोटर द इंड्यूस्ड मैग्नेटिक फील्ड ऑफ स्टेटर वाइंडिंग इंड्यूज ए करेंट इन रोटर, दिस इंड्यूस्ड रोटर करेंट प्रोड्यूज ए सेकेंड मैग्नेटिक फील्ड विच ट्राइज टू अपोज द स्टेटिक मैग्नेटिक फील्ड एंड दिस क्यूज द रोटर टू रोटेट। थ्री फेज स्क्वायर मोटर इज ए वर्क होर्स ऑफ इंडस्ट्री, इट इज रग्ड एंड रिलायबल एंड इज बाई फार द मोस्ट कॉमन मोटर टाइप्स यूज्ड इन द इंडस्ट्री, दैट इज थ्री फेज स्क्वायर केज इंडक्शन थ्री फेज मोटर। दीज मोटर्स ड्राइव पंप, ब्लोअर्स, फैंस, कंप्रेसर, कन्वेयर एंड प्रोडक्शन लाइन। द थ्री फेज इंडक्शन मोटर हैज थ्री वाइंडिंग, इज कनेक्टेड टू सेपरेट फेज ऑफ पावर सप्लाई। सेकेंड इज डी सी मोटर, दैट इज डायरेक्ट करंट मोटर। डायरेक्ट करंट मोटर एज नेम इम्प्लाइज यूज डायरेक्ट यूनिडायरेक्शनल करंट एंड डायरेक्ट करंट मोटर आर यूज इन स्पेशल एप्लीकेशन वेयर हाई टॉर्क, हाई स्टार्टिंग टॉर्क इज रिक्वायर्ड और वेयर स्मूथ एक्सेलरेशन ओवर ए ब्रॉड स्पीड रेंज इज रिक्वायर्ड। थर्ड इज सिंक्रोनस मोटर, AC power is fed to the stator of synchronous motor. The rotor is fed by DC from the separate source. The rotor magnetic field locks onto the stator rotating magnetic field and rotate at the same speed. The speed of rotor is the function of supply frequency and number of magnetic poles in the stator. While the induction motor rotates with a slip, that is RPM is less than the synchronous speed. The synchronous motor rotates with no slip and RPM is same as the synchronous speed. Governed by the supply frequency and number of poles, the slip energy is provided by the DC excitation power. Now we can see motor characteristics. One is motor speed. The speed of motor is the number of revolution is given time frame, typically revolutionary per revolution per minute. The speed of AC motor depend on the frequency of input power and the number of poles for which the motor is wound. The synchronous speed in RPM is given by the following equation, where the frequency in hertz and cycle per second. Synchronous speed RPM is given by 120 into frequency divided by number of poles. Indian motor have synchronous speed like 3000, 1500, 1000, 750, 600, 1500 or 375 RPM, corresponding to number of poles being 2, 4, 6, 10, 12 or 16. Always even and given the main frequency of 50 cycle per second. The actual speed with which the motor is operate will be less than the synchronous speed. The difference between the synchronous speed and full load speed is called the slip and measured in percentage and calculating using this formula, synchronous speed minus full load speed, full load rated speed divided by synchronous speed into 100. As per relation stated above, the speed of AC motor is determined by the number of motor poles and by the input frequency. It can also be then theoretically speed of AC motor can be varied infinitely by changing the frequency. Manufacturing guidelines should be referred for practical limit of speed variation. With the addition of variable frequency drive, the speed of motor can be desired as well as increased. Power factor of the motor is given by cos y equal to kilowatt divided by kVA. As the load on the motor comes down, the magnitude of the active current reduces. However, there is a no corresponding reduction in the magnetic current, which is proportional to the supply voltage, with the result that motor power factor reduces. With a reduction in the applied load, induction motor, especially those operating below
दियर रेटेड कैपेसिटी आर मेन रीजन फॉर द लो पावर फैक्टर इन द इलेक्ट्रिकल सिस्टम और इलेक्ट्रिक सिस्टम. मोटर एफिशिएंसी, टू इंपॉर्टेंट एट्रीब्यूट्स रिलेटिंग टू एफिशिएंसी ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिसिटी यूज्ड बाय एसी इंडक्शन मोटर आर एफिशिएंसी डिफाइंड एज द रेशियो ऑफ मैकेनिकल एनर्जी डिलीवर्ड एट द रोटेटिंग शाफ्ट टू द इलेक्ट्रिकल एनर्जी इनपुट एट द इट्स टर्मिनल एंड पावर फैक्टर ऑफ मोटर. लाइक अदर इंडक्टिव लोड आर कैरेक्टराइज्ड बाय द पावर फैक्टर लेस देन वन. एज ए रिजल्ट द टोटल करंट ड्रॉ नीडेड टू डिलीवर द सेम रियल पावर एज हायर फॉर द लोड कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स बाय द बाय ए हायर पावर फैक्टर. एज इंपॉर्टेंट इफेक्ट ऑफ ऑपरेटिंग विद द पावर फैक्टर लेस देन वन इज दैट रेजिस्टेंस लॉसेज इन वायरिंग ऑफ द स्ट्रीम ऑफ द मोटर विल बी हायर सिंस दीज आर प्रोपोर्शनल टू द स्क्वायर ऑफ करंट. Thus, both the high value of efficiency and power factor close to unity are desired for the efficient overall operation in the plant. The squirrel cage motors are normally more efficient than the slip ring motor, and higher speed motors are normally more efficient than the lower speed motor. Efficiency is also the function of motor temperature. Total employed fan pulled motor are more efficient than the skin protected drip roof motor. Also with most equipment, motor efficiency increases with the rated capacity. The efficiency of motor is determined by the intrinsic losses that can be reduced only by changing in motor design. Intrinsic losses are defined speed losses that is independent of motor load and variable losses that is dependent on load. Fixed losses consist of magnetic core losses and friction and windage losses, and magnetic core losses, sometimes called iron losses, consist of eddy current losses and eddy current stasis losses. In the stator, they vary with the core material and geometry and with the input voltage. Friction and windage losses are caused by the friction and the wearing of the motor, and aerodynamic losses associated with the ventilation fan and other rotating parts. Variable losses consist of resistance losses in the stator and the rotor and miscellaneous hysteresis losses. Resistance to current flow in the stator and rotor result in heat generation that is proportional to the resistance of material and square of current. And hysteresis losses arise from variety of sources are difficult to either measure directly or to calculate, but generally proportional to the square of rotor current. Part load performance characteristics by the motor also depend on its design. Both efficiency and power factor fall is very low level at low load, and so is the effect of load on the power factor and efficiency. It can be seen the power factor drops sharply as part load, and so is the effect of speed on the power factor. Fitted test with determining efficiency. First is no load test. Motor is run at rated voltage and frequency without any shaft load input power. Current, frequency, and voltage are noted. The no load power factor is quite low, and hence the low power factor of wattmeter are required. Or from the input power stator I square R losses under no load are subtracted to give the sum of friction and windage core losses. To separate core and friction, F and W friction and windage losses, test is repeated at a variable voltage. It is useful to plot no load input kilowatt versus voltage, and the interaction is friction of windage kilowatt loss component. यहाँ पर एक कर्व है जैसे कि एफिशिएंसी वर्सेस पावर फैक्टर वर्सेस लोड. तो एफिशिएंसी डिवाइड बाय पावर फैक्टर वर्सेस लोड, ये एफिशिएंसी का कर्व है यहाँ पर, ये पावर फैक्टर का कर्व है. तो रेटेड लोड के अकॉर्डिंग इनका लगाया है लोड वर्सेस पावर फैक्टर एफिशिएंसी के रेस्पेक्ट में, और यहाँ पर स्पीड वर्सेस पावर फैक्टर का कर्व है. ये सिंक्रोनस स्पीड यहाँ पर दिखाई गई है और ये पावर फैक्टर दिखाया गया है. तो फुल लोड पावर फैक्टर एट वेरियस स्पीड दिखाया गया है यहाँ पर, और एफिशिएंसी है ओवरऑल लोड पर दिखाई गई है. फिर हम देखें यहाँ पर फ्रिक्शन एंड विंडेज लॉसेज एंड कोर लॉसेज आर इक्वल टू नो लोड पावर माइनस के नो लोड करंट स्क्वायर माइनस के स्टेटर रेजिस्टेंस. स्टेटर एंड रोटर आई स्क्वायर आर लॉसेज के अकॉर्डिंग हम देखें, द स्टेटर वाइंडिंग रेजिस्टेंस इज डायरेक्टली मेजर्ड बाय ए ब्रिज और वोल्ट एम्पियर मेथड. द रेजिस्टेंस मस्ट बी करेक्टेड टू ऑपरेटिंग टेम्परेचर. For modern motor, the operating temperature is likely to be in the range of 100 degrees Celsius to 120 degrees Celsius, and necessary correction should be made. Correction of 75 degrees Celsius may be inaccurate. The correction factor is given by R2 divided by R1 equal to 2 235 plus T2 divided by 235 plus T1, where T1 is ambient temperature and T2 is the operating temperature. The rotor resistance can be determined from the locked rotor test at reduced frequency, but the rotor I square R losses are measured from the measurement of rotor slip. Rotor I square R loss is equal to slip into stator input minus K stator I square R losses minus K core losses. Accurate measurement of slip is possibly by a stroboscope or non-contact type tachometer. Slip also must be corrected to operating temperature. Stray load losses. These losses are difficult to measure with any accuracy. IEEE standard 112 gives a complicated method which is rarely used on shop floor. IS and IEC standard take a fixed value of 0.5% of input, and actual value of stray losses is likely to be more. And IEEE 112 specifies values of 0.9% to 1.8%. That is motor rating. Motor rating versus stray losses. If motor rating is 1 to 125 HP, then stray loss is 1.8%. 125 to 500 HP, then stray loss is 1.5%. 500 to 2500 HP, then motor stray loss is 1.2%. And above the 2500, stray loss is 0.9%. Pointer for users. It must be clear that accurate determination of efficiency is very difficult. This same motor test by different method and by same method by different manufacturer can be take different of difference of 2% in the view of this. The selection high efficiency motor follow can be done. When purchasing large number of small motor or large motor, ask for detailed test certificate. It is, if possible, try to remain present during the test. This will add cost. See the efficiency value are specified without any tolerance. Check the actual input current and flow art if replacement is done. For new motors, keep a record of no load input power and current. Use value of efficiency for comparison and for comparing relay to measured and input for all calculations. Estimation of efficiency in the field can be done as follows. The measured stator resistance and corrected to operating temperature from rated current value, I square R losses can be calculated. From rated speed and output, rotor I square R losses are calculated. From no load test, core and frequency, friction and windage losses are determined by stray losses. The method is illustrated by the following example. This is motor specific, the rated power is 34 kilowatt, 75, 45 HP, voltage is 450 volt, current is 57 ampere, speed is 1475 RPM, insulation class is strength is LD200, connection is delta. No load test के जो डेटा आ रहे हैं, वोल्टेज आ रहा है 415 वोल्ट, करंट आ रही है 16.1 एम्पीयर, फ्रीक्वेंसी आ रही है 15 हर्ट्ज, स्टेटर फेज रेजिस्टेंस 30 डिग्री सेल्सियस पर आ रहा है 0.264, नो लोड पावर आ रही है यहाँ पर 1063.74। कैलकुलेट द आयरन प्लस फ्रिक्शन एंड वोल्टेज लॉसेज, कैलकुलेट द स्टेटर रेजिस्टेंस 120 डिग्री सेल्सियस। तो स्टेटर रेजिस्टेंस 120 डिग्री सेल्सियस क्या हो जाएगा, R2 = R1 = 35 + T1 / 235 + T1। Calculate the stator copper losses at operating temperature of the resistance of 120 degrees Celsius. Calculate full load and rotor input, assuming rotor losses are slip times motor input. Determine the motor input, assuming the stray losses are 0.5% of motor rated power. And calculate the motor full load efficiency and full load power factor. So, iron losses and friction losses ke according hum dekhen. Iron losses plus friction losses yahan par full load power aa jayegi 1063.74. तो स्टेटर कॉपर लॉसेज यहाँ पर 30 डिग्री सेल्सियस पर क्या होगा, 3 into 16.5 divided by √3 का स्क्वायर करंट 2.64 तो यह आ जाएगा 68.43 और PI plus PF2 क्या बोलूँगा P no load minus के PST copper losses आ जाएगा यहाँ पर स्टेटर कॉपर लॉसेज तो यह आ जाएगा 995.34 स्टेटर रेजिस्टेंस हम निकालें तो 120 डिग्री पर आ जाएगा ये 0.64 120 plus 235 divided by 30 plus 235 तो यह आ जाएगा 0.35 ओम पर फेज। स्टेटर कॉपर लॉसेज एट फुल लोड क्या आ जाएगा यहाँ पर 120 डिग्री सेल्सियस पर 10 to 57 / √3 का और स्क्वायर 2.354 तो यह आ जाएगा 1115.1 बार। फुल लोड स्लिप की बात करें, स्लिप इक्वल टू आ जाएगा 150 स्लिप स्पीड माइनस के जो एक्चुअल स्पीड है, तो यह आ जाएगा डिवाइड बाई 1500, यह जाएगा 0.017। तो रोटर इनपुट आ जाएगा आउटपुट डिवाइड बाई 1 माइनस स्लिप, तो यह आ जाएगा रोटर इनपुट। मोटर फुल लोड इनपुट पावर आ जाएगी यहाँ पर PR प्लस कॉपर लॉसेज प्लस के फ्रैक्शन लॉसेज विंटेज लॉसेज प्लस स्टील लॉसेज। तो ये यहाँ पर सारी चीजें आ जाएंगी यहाँ पर, जैसे कि पीआर हो गया कॉपर लॉसेज, और कॉपर लॉसेज प्लस फ्रिक्शन लॉसेज हो जाएगा यहाँ पर, और पिस्टन लॉसेज यहाँ पर आ गया 0.005 × 34,000। तो ये स्टील लॉसेज है 0.5% रेटेड आउटपुट दे रखा है, एज्यूम किया हुआ है। मोटर एफिशिएंसी आ जाएगी पी आउटपुट डिवाइड बाय पी इनपुट इनटू 100, उससे मोटर एफिशिएंसी आ जाएगी। तो पी आउटपुट डिवाइड बाय पी इनपुट इनटू 100 से मोटर एफिशिएंसी आ गई 92.2%। फुल लोड पावर फैक्टर आ गया पी इनपुट डिवाइड बाय अंडर रूट 3 इनटू वी इनटू आईएफएल। तो आईएफएल फुल लोड करंट के अकॉर्डिंग यहां पर निकालना है, तो ये आ जाएगा 0.90। तो द मेजरमेंट ऑफ स्टील लोड लॉसेज इज वेरी डिफिकल्ट एंड नॉट प्रैक्टिकल इवन ऑन टेस्ट बेड्स। The actual value of steel losses of motor up to 200 HP is likely to be 1% to 3% compared to 0.5% assumed by standard. The value of full load slip taken from the nameplate data is not accurate. Actual measurement under full load condition will give a better result. The fractional vintage losses really are part of the shaft output. However, in the above calculation, it is not added to the rated shaft output. Before calculating the rotor input power, the error, however, is minor. When the motor is rewound, there is a fair chance that the resistance per phase would be increased due to the venting material quality and losses would be higher. It would be interesting to assess the effect of normal 10% increase in the resistance per phase. Motor selection. So, how we can select the motor types and motor quality? The primary technical consideration defining the motor choice for any particular application is torque required by the load, especially the relationship between the maximum torque generated by the motor, breakdown torque, and the torque requirement for startup, locked rotor torque, during the acceleration period. The duty load cycle determines the thermal loading on the motor. One consideration with the total employed fan employed motor is that the cooling may be insufficient when the motor is operated at the speed below its rated value. Ambient operating condition affect the motor choice. Special motor design are available for the coercive and dusty atmosphere with the high temperature and restricted physical space. ETC, it is estimated for the switching frequency and usually detected by the process where the automatic and manual control can help in the selecting the appropriate motor for the duty cycle. This deep top motor will be placed in balance of the plant electrical system. It is another consideration. It is load variation are required. इसे एग्जांपल के लिए हम देखें यहाँ पर। फॉर एग्जांपल एज ए रिजल्ट ऑफ फ्रीक्वेंट स्टार्ट एंड स्टॉप ऑफ लार्ज कंपोनेंट लाइक कंप्रेसर एंड द रिजल्टिंग लार्ज वोल्टेज ड्रॉप कुड बी डिटरमेंटल टू अदर इक्विपमेंट। रिलायबिलिटी और रिलायबिलिटी ऑफ द प्राइम इंपोर्टेंस इन मेनी केसेज। हाउएवर डिजाइनर एंड प्रोसेस इंजीनियर सीकिंग रिलायबिलिटी विल ग्रोसली ओवरसाइज्ड इक्विपमेंट leading to sub-optimal energy performance. Good knowledge of process parameter and better understanding of plant power system can be added in reducing oversizing with no loss of reliability. Inventory in another consideration, many large industries use standard equipment which can easily be served or replaced, thereby reducing the stock of spare part that must be maintained and minimize shutdown time. This practice affects the choice of motors that might be provide better energy performance in a specific appliance. Shorter lead time for securing individual motor from supplier would help reduce the need for this practice. Price is another issue. Many users are first cost sensitive, leading to purchase of less expensive motor that may be more costly on life cycle basis because of lower efficiency. For example, energy efficiency motors or other specially designed motors typically save within a few years an amount of money equal to several times the incremental cost of energy efficient motor. Over a standard efficiency motor, few of silent selection issues are given below. In the selection process, the power drawn at 75% of loading can be meaningful indicator of energy efficiency. Reactive power drawn by the motor. Indian standard 325 for the standard motor allow 15% tolerance on efficiency for motor अप टू 15 किलोवाट, 50 किलोवाट रेटिंग एंड 10% ऑफ मोटर ओवर 50 किलोवाट रेटिंग। द इंडियन स्टैंडर्ड IS 8785 एड्रेस टेक्निकल परफॉर्मेंस ऑफ स्टैंडर्ड मोटर, वाइल IS 12615 एड्रेस इज द एफिशिएंसी क्राइटेरिया ऑफ हाई एफिशिएंसी मोटर। बोथ फॉलो IEC 34-2 टेस्ट मेथोडोलॉजी वेयर स्टील लॉसेज आर एज्यूम्ड एज 0.5% ऑफ इनपुट पावर। By the IES test method, the losses are understated and if gone goes by IEEE test methodology. The motor efficiency value would be further lowered. It would be prudent for Boyer to produce pressure motor based on test certificate rather than the labeled value. The energy saving by motor replacement can be worked out by the simple relation kilowatt saving, kilowatt output into 1 efficiency old minus given divided by efficiency new. With n old and n new is the existing and proposed motor efficiency value. The cost benefit can be worked out on the basis of premium required for high efficiency versus worth of annual saving. Energy efficient motor. Energy efficient motor, that is EEM, are the one in which design improvements are incorporated especially to increase the operating efficiency over motor of standard design. Design improvement focus on reducing the intrinsic motor losses. Improvement include the use of lower loss silicon steel and longer core to increase the active material. Thicker wire to reduce the resistance and thinner limitation and smaller air gap between the stator and rotor. Copper instead of aluminum bars in the rotor and superior bearing and smaller fan. Energy efficient motor now available in India operate with the efficiencies that are typically 3-4% higher than the standard motor. In keeping with the stipulation of BIS, energy efficient motors are designed to operate without loss in efficiency at load between 75% to 100% of rated capacity. And this may result in major benefit of bearing the load applications. The power factor is about the same and may be higher for standard motor. Furthermore, energy efficient motor have lower operating temperature and noise level and greater ability to accelerate high inertia load and are less affected by the supply voltage fluctuation. So this is the standard versus high efficiency motor. These are high efficiency motor and these are standard motor. So high efficiency motor have high efficiency. Stator and I2R losses. Measures adopted for energy efficient address such as loss especially are under stator and rotor I2R losses. These losses are major losses and typically account of 55% to 60% of total losses. I2R losses are heating losses resulting from the current passage through the stator and rotor conductor. And I2R losses are function of the conductor resistance and the square of current. Resistance and conductor is the function of conductor material length and cross section area. The suitable selection of copper conductor size will reduce the resistance and reducing the motor current is more most rapidly accomplished by decreasing the magnetizing component of current. This involves lowering the operating flux density and possible shortening of air gap. Rotor I2R losses are the function of the rotor conductor, usually aluminum and rotor slip, and utilization of copper conductor will be reduce the winding resistance and motor operation closer to synchronous speed will also reduce the rotor I2R losses. Core losses. Core losses are those found in the stator rotor magnetic steel and are due to the stasis effect and eddy current effect during the 50 Hz magnetization of the core material. These losses are independent of load and account of 20 to 25% of total losses. The stasis losses which have the function of flux density are reduced by utilization low loss grade of silicon steel elimination and the reduction of flux density is achieved by the suitable increase in the core length of stator and rotor. Eddy current losses are generated by circulating current within the core steel laminations and these are reduced by using the thinner laminations. Friction and windage losses. Friction and windage losses result for bearing friction, windage and circulating air through the motor and account of 18 to 20% of total losses. These losses are independent of load and the reduction in heat generated by stator and rotor losses permit in the use of smaller fan. And the windage losses also reduced with the diameter of fan leading to reduction in the windage losses. Stator load losses ki baat karein. The losses vary according to the square of the load current and are caused by linkage flux induced by the load current in the lamination and account of 40 to 55% of total losses. These losses are reduced by careful selection of slot number, tooth per slot, geometry and air gap. Energy efficiency motor cover a wide range of rating and full load efficiency are higher by 3 to 7%. The mounting dimension are also maintained as IS12312 enable the PG replacement. As a result of modification to improve the performance and the cost energy efficient motor are higher than those of standard motor. Higher cost will often will be paid back rapidly in this saved operating cost. In particular, new appliance and end of life motor replacement in case where the existing motor are not reached to the end of their useful life. Economics will be less clearly positive because the favorable economics of the energy efficient motor are based on the saving of operating cost, and these may be certain cases which are generally economically ill situated for the energy efficient motor, and these include highly intermittent duty or special torque applications such as hoist and cranes and traction drive, punch press, machine tool and centrifugal. In addition, energy efficiency design of multi-speed motor are generally not available. Furthermore, energy efficient motor are not yet available for many special appliances, that is for flame-proof operation of oil field or fire pump or very low speed application, that is below 750 rpm. Also, most energy efficient motors produced today are designed only for the continuous duty cycles operations. If the tendency of oversizing of one hand and ground realities like voltage, frequency variation and efficacy of rewinding in case of worn out on the other hand, benefit of EEM can be achieved only by careful selection, implementation and operation and maintenance effort of energy manager. The summary of energy efficiency improvement in EEM is given by iron, power losses area iron, efficiency improvement, we can see a use of thinner gauge and thinner loss core steel reduce eddy current losses, and longer core add more steel to design and which reduce the losses due to the lower operating flux density, stator ISR losses. Use of more copper and large conductor increase the cross section area of stator winding, and this low resistance of winding and reduce the losses due to the current flow. Rotor ISR losses. Use of large rotor conductor and increase size of the cross section area and lowering the conductor resistance and losses due to the current flow. Friction and bendage. Use of low loss fan design reduce the losses due to the air movement. Stay and load losses. Use of optimizing for optimized design and district quality control procedure minimizing stay load losses. Factor affecting the energy efficiency and minimizing the motor losses in operation. Power supply quality. Motor performance is affected considerably by the quality of input power, that is actual voltage and frequency available at the motor terminal Y, rated value as well as voltage and frequency variation and voltage unbalance across the three set. Motor in India must comply with the standard set by Bureau of Indian Standard of Tolerance to Variation in Input Power Quality. The BIS standard of specify that the motor should be capable of delivering its rated output with the voltage variation of ±6% and frequency variation of ±3%, and fluctuation must be larger than. These are quite common in the utility supplied electricity in India. Voltage fluctuation can be derived impact on motor performance. The general effect of voltage and frequency variation on motor performance are presented. Voltage unbalance, the condition where the voltage in the three phase are not equal and can be still more detrimental to motor performance and rotor life. And unbalance typically occur as the result of supply single phase load and disproportionality from other of the phase. And it can also be result from the use of different keys of cable in the distribution system. An example of effect of voltage unbalance of motor performance. So these are the option available for energy to ensure near the voltage terminal include. First is load power factor improvement by the providing एचिंग ऑफ पावर फैक्टर कैपेसिटर एंड सेकंड इज मिनिमाइजिंग एंड केबल वोल्टेज ड्रॉप फ्रॉम सब स्टेशन टू मोटर टर्मिनल एंड थर्ड इज ट्रांसफार्मर टाइप चेंजिंग इज रिक्वायर्ड इन द केस ऑफ कंसिस्टेंस एंड कंटिन्यूस वोल्टेज सिचुएशन इफेक्ट एंड एग्जाम्पल एंड द इफेक्ट ऑफ वोल्टेज अनबैलेंस ऑन मोटर परफॉर्मेंस फर्स्ट इज अनबैलेंस इन करंट 0.4 प्रीसेट प्रेजेंट परसेंट अनबैलेंस इन वोल्टेज 17.4% इन 14% परसेंट अनबैलेंस इन वोल्टेज डिफाइंड एज 100 बी मैक्सिमम माइनस बी एवरेज डिवाइड बाई बी एवरेज वेयर बी एवरेज और बी मैक्सिमम आर द बी मैक्सिमम इज लार्जेस्ट एंड द वोल्टेज ऑफ द थ्री फेज सप्लाई रेस्पेक्टिवली The option can be exercised to minimize the voltage unbalance include balancing any single phase load equally among all the three load and segregating any single phase load which distribute or disturb the load balance and field from them from a separating band and transformer. Motor loading की बात करें motor loading क्या loading of the motor can be estimated by the following relation. First is loading input power drawn by the motor at existing load into 100. Nameplate full load kilowatt rating, nameplate full load motor efficiency, and loading input power drawn by the motor at existing load into 100 divided by under 3 into kV into I cos phi. Never assume power factor. Loading should be estimated as ratio of current. Reducing under loading. Probability the most common practice of contributing to sub optional motor efficiency is that of under loading. Under loading result in lower efficiency and power factor. And higher than necessary first cost for the motor and related control equipment. Underloading is common for several reasons. Original equipment manufacturing tends to use of large safety factor in motor they select. Underloading of motor may also occur from under utilization of equipment. For example, machine tool equipment manufacturing provide a motor rated for the full capacity load of equipment. X depth of cut in the latch machine. The user may needed this full capacity rarely, resulting in underloaded operation most of the time. And another common reason for underloading is selection of large motor to enable the output to be maintained at desired level. And even when the input voltage are abnormal low, finally underloading also results from the selecting a large motor for a application requiring a high torque. Where a special motor designed for high torque would have been suitable. A careful evaluation of the load would determine the capacity of motor that should be selected and another aspect of consider to the incremental gain and efficiency achievement by changing the motor and larger motor have inherently higher rated efficiency than a smaller motor. Therefore, the replacement of motor operating at 60 to 70% of capacity of higher is generally not recommended. However, there are no rigid rules governing motor selection, saving potential need to be evaluation case to case basis and while downsizing it may be preferred to select the energy efficient motor and efficiency which may higher than that of the standard motor higher capacity. For motors which consistently operate at load below 40% of rated speed, rated capacity, and inexpensive and effective measurement must be operated at star mode. The change from standard data operation to start operation involves reconfiguration and wiring of the three phase of power input at the terminal box. Operating in star mode lead to voltage reduction by the factor of root 3 and motor is electrically downsized by the star mode operation but the performance characteristics as a function of star load remain unchanged. Thus full load operation in star mode gives the higher efficiency and power factor than partial load operation in the delta mode. However, motor operation in the star mode is possibly only for appliances where the torque to speed requirement is lower at reduced load. As speed of motor reduces in star mode, this option may have avoided in case of motor is connected to the production facility where output is related to the motor speed. For appliance with high initial torque and low running torque needed, delta star starter are also available in market, which helps in load flowing derating of the electrical motor after initial startup. Sizing to variable load. Sizing to variable load. Industrial motor frequently operated under the varying load condition due to the process requirement. A common practice in case where such variable load are found to be selective motor based on the highest anticipated load. In many instances, an alternative approach is typically less costly, more efficient, and provide equally satisfactory operation. With this approach, the optimum rating for the motor is selected on the basis of load duration curve for the particular application. And thus, rather than selecting a motor in a higher rating than could operate at a fully capacity for only a short period, a motor would be selected with the rating slightly lower than the peak anticipated load and would operate a overload and short period of time. Since the operating within the thermal capability of the motor insulating was a greatest concern in the motor operating at higher than its rated load, and the motor rating is selected as that of which the resultant same temperature rise under continuous full load operation as weighted average temperature rise over the actual operating cycle, and under extreme load change, frequent start and stop, and high initial load, the method of calculating the motor rating is unsuitable since it must be underestimated, and hearing that would occur where load varies substantially with the time. In addition to proper motor sizing and control strategy employed, can be significant impact on the motor electrical use. Traditionally, mechanical means, that is, throttle valve in the piping system has been used when the lower voltage is required. More efficient speed control mechanisms include the multi-speed motor, eddy current coupling, frequent coupling, and solid state electronics variable speed drive. Then we can see power factor correction. As noted earlier, induction motors are characterized by the power factor less than unity and leading to the lower overall efficiency and higher overall operating cost and associated with the plant electrical system. Capacitors connected in parallel with the motor are typically used to improve the power factor. The impact of power factor correction include reduced KVA rating, KVA demand, and hence reduced utility demand charge and reduced I2R losses in the cable upstream, and capacitor and the hence reduced energy charge and reduced a voltage drop in the cable, and leading to the improvement is regulation and increase in the overall efficiency of plant electrical system. It should be noted that power factor capacitor improves the power factor from the point of installation back to the generating side, and it means that if the power factor is installed at the starting terminal of the motor, it will not be improve the operating power factor of motor, but the power factor from starting terminal to the power generating side will improve. The benefit of power factor may be only upstream side. The size of capacity required for particular motor depend upon the no load reactive KVA drawn by the motor, which can be determined only from no load testing of motor. In general, the capacitor is then selected not exceed 90% of the no load KVAR of the motor. Higher capacitor should result in overvoltage and motor burnout. Alternatively, typically power factor of the standard motor can provide the basis of conservation estimation of the capacitor rating of use of different size motor. The capacitor rating for power connection by direct connection of inductive motor is shown. From the above table, this may be noted that the required capacitance KVAR increase with the decrease in the speed of motor, and magnetizing current required for low speed motor is more in common. There is motor rating, capacity rating in motor speed, that is 3000 speed. Motor rating is 5 HP, and capacitor rating for power factor correction on direct DC, direct connection to induction motor. So according to table, we can see the rate. And comparison of the high speed motor to the same HP of motor and set the reduction in the line current and the associated energy efficiency gain are reflected backward from the point of application of the capacitor, and the improvement of overall system efficiency is achieved when the capacitor is connected across the motor terminal. As compared to some bare further upstream in the plant electrical system, however, the economic scale associated with the cost of capacitor and the labor required to install them place an economic limit of the lowest desired capacitor size. we can see the maintenance. Inadequate maintenance of motor can be significantly increase losses and lead to unreliable operation. For example, improper lubricants can be good, increased friction both the motor and associated drive transmission equipment, resistance losses in the motor, which rise with the temperature with increase, and providing adequate ventilation and keeping motor cooling down and clean can be help dissipated heat to reduce the excessive losses. The life of insulation of motor would also be longer for every 10 degree increase in the motor operating temperature over the recommendation peak, and the time before rewinding would be needed to estimate to be half. The checklist of good maintenance practice to be help ensure proper motor operation and would include inspecting motor regularly for wearing the house and to reduce the friction losses and dirt and dust and motor ventilation dust to ensure the proper heat dissipation. Checking the load condition to ensure that the motor is not over underloaded, and the change in motor load from the last test indicate in change in drive load, and the QD which should be understood. Lubricant appropriately. Manufacturing generally gives the recommendation for how and when lubricate the motor, and inadequate information can be huge problem as I noted above. Over lubricant can also create problem. Excess oil and grease of motor bearing can be enter the motor and saturate the motor insulation, and causing premature failure and creating a fire risk. Check listing periodically for proper alignment of the motor and drive disc equipment. Improper alignment can be huge. Shift and bearing to wear quickly and resulting in damage to both motor and driving equipment. Ensuring that the supply wiring and terminal box are properly sized and installed, and inspect regularly in connection at the motor and starter to ensure that they are clean and tight. According to age, we can see most motor core in the India are manufactured from silicon steel and decarbonized and cold rolled steel, and electrical properties in which do not change in measurably with age. However, the poor maintenance, inadequate lubricants of the bearing and insufficient cleaning of air cooling passes can cause a deterioration in motor efficiency over time, and ambient condition can also be a detrimental effect on the motor performance. For example, excessively high temperature, high duct loading, corrosive atmosphere and humidity can impair insulation properties. Mechanical stress due to the load result can lead to mitigating, and however with adequate care and motor performance can be maintained. Next, we can see rewinding effect on energy efficiency. In common practice in industry, rewind burn out motor. The population of rewind motor in some industries exceeds 50% of total population. Careful rewinding can also be sometimes maintained motor efficiency at prevent level. But in most cases, losses in the efficiency result in rewinding can affect the number of factors that contribute to deteriorate motor efficiency, winding and slot losses. And the binding material insulating performance or operating temperature, for example, common problem occur when heat is applied to the strip or the binding, and the insulation between the lamination can be damaged, thereby increasing eddy current losses, and change in the air gap may affect power factor and output torque. However, in proper measures are taken, motor efficiency can be maintained. In the some cases, increase after binding efficiency can be improved by changing the binding design through the power factor and affect the process. Using the wires of great loss, cross section, slot size permitting would result or reduce the stator losses, thereby increasing the efficiency. However, it is generally recommended that a original design of motor be prevented during the rewind, and unless there are specific tow or load related reasons for redesign. The impact of rewinding of motors, efficiency and power factor can be easily assessed if the no load losses of motor are known before the after rewinding. Maintaining documentation of no load losses and no load speed from the time of purchase to each motor can facilitate assistance this impact. For example, comparison to load torque, load current and stator winding or stator resistance per phase of rewound motor with original no load current and stator resistance is same voltage can be one the indicator to assess the efficacy efficiency of rewinding. Speed control of AC induction motor. Traditionally, DC motor have been employed when the variable speed capability are designed or were desired.
By controlling the armature voltage and field current of separately excited DC motor, a wide range of output speed can be obtained. DC motor are available in the wide range of size, but their use of generally restricted to few low speed and low to medium power application like the machine tool and rolling mill because of the problem with the mechanical calculation in large area. Also, they are restricted for the use in clean, non-hazardous area and because of the risk of sparking at the brushes. And DC motors are also expensive relative to AC motors. Because the limitation of DC system, AC motor are increasing the focus on variable speed application. Both AC synchronous and induction motor are suitable for variable speed control. Induction motor are generally more popular, however, because of their ruggedness and lower maintenance requirement. AC induction motor are expensive, half or less of the cost of DC motor are also provided a high power to weight ratio, about the twice than the DC motor. Induction motor is asynchronous motor, and the speed of which can be varied by changing the supply frequency. The motor strategy to be adopted in any particular case will be depend on the number of factors including the investment cost and load reliability and any special control requirement. Thus for example, thus for any particular application to desire
return the review of
load correction, historical data development and process flow and features required of speed control and the electrical traffic and investment cost would be precipitic and the selection of speed control system. The characteristics of load are particularly important. Load refers essentially to the torque output and corresponding speed required. Load can be broadly classified as either constant power and constant torque, and constant torque load are those on which the output power requirement may vary with the speed of operation, but the torque does not vary. Conveyor, rotary and constant displacement pump are typically example of constant torque load, and the variable torque load are those for which torque required varies with the speed of operation, and centrifugal pump and fan are typically example of variable torque load. Square varies as the square of speed, and constant power load are those for which the torque requirement typically changed inversely with speed. Machine tool are a typical example of constant power load. The large potential of electricity saving from variable speed drives is generally enable to torque appliance. For example, centrifugal pumps and fans, where the power requirement change as the cube of speed, and constant torque load are also suitable for BHD applications. Motor speed control. Multi-speed motor ki baat kare hum. Motor can be bound such as 2 speed in the ratio of 2 and 5 can be obtained. Motor can be also be bound with 2 separate winding, each giving 2 operation speed. For the total of 4 speed, multi-speed motor can be designed for application involving constant torque, variable torque. For constant output power, multi-speed motor are suitable for application which require limited speed control, 2 or 4 fixed speed instead of continuous variable speed. In which cases they tend to vary economical, they have lower efficiency than the single speed motor. Adjustable frequency AC drive. Adjustable frequency drive are also commonly called inverter. They are available in the range of kilowatt rating for friction of 750 kilowatt. They are designed to operate standard induction motor. They allow them to easily adapt to existing system. The inverter are often sold separately because of the motor may already be in place. If necessary, a motor can be included with the drive or supplied separately. The basis drive consists of inverter itself, which converts 50 Hz incoming power to a variable frequency and variable voltage. The variable frequency in actual requirement, which will control the motor speed. There are 3 major types of inverter designed available today. These are known as current source inverter, variable voltage inverter (BVI), and pulse width modulated inverter (PW) inverter. At DC current drive ki baat karein. DC drive technology is oldest form of electrical speed control. एंड द ड्राइव सिस्टम कॉन्सिस्ट ऑफ डीसी मोटर एंड कंट्रोलर. द मोटर इज कंस्ट्रक्टेड विद आर्मेचर एंड फील्ड वाइंडिंग. बोथ दीज वाइंडिंग रिक्वायर्ड डीसी एक्साइटेशन फॉर मोटर ऑपरेशन. यूजुअली द फील्ड वाइंडिंग इज एक्साइटेड विद द कॉन्स्टेंट लेवल वोल्टेज फ्रॉम द कंट्रोलर. देन अप्लाइंग ए डीसी वोल्टेज फ्रॉम द कंट्रोलर टू आर्मेचर एंड मोटर विल ऑपरेट द मोटर. The armature of the motor will operate the motor and armature connection are made through the brush and commutator assembly and the speed of motor is directly proportional to the applied voltage. The controller in a phase control bridge rectifier with the logic circuit to control the DC voltage delivered to the motor armature. The speed control is achieved by regulating the armature voltage to the motor and often a TACO generator is included to achieve the good speed regulation. The TACO must be mounted on the motor and product a speed feedback signal that is used within the controller. Bound rotor AC drive that is self slip ring induction motor. Bound rotor motor drive use a specially constructed a motor to accomplish speed control. The motor rotor is constructed with the winding which are brought out the motor through the slip ring on the rotor speed. These windings are connected to the controlling which passes variable resistance to in series with the winding and the torque performance of motor can be controlled using variable resistor. And rotor motor are most common in the range of 3 HP, 300 HP and above. Motor load survey methodology. Large industries have a massive population of load. LT motor, load survey of LT motor can be taken up methodology to identify the improvement option as illustrated in the following case study. First is sampling criteria. Twice the objective of selecting representative LT motor drives among the motor population for analyzing the criteria consideration. Utilization factor, hour of operation with a preference given to continuous operated drive motor. Sample representative basis, where one drive motor analysis can be reasoned as the representative of population, that is cooling tower fans, air washer unit adi. And conventional power basis, where drive motor and inefficient capacity control can be machine side and fluctuating load curve and are looked into. Measurement ki baat karein, student on selected LT motor involve a measurement of electrical load parameter namely volt, ampere, power factor and kilowatt drawn. Observation on machine side parameters such as speed, load, pressure, temperature, etc. as relevant are also taken. Ability of online instrument for Roentgen measurement. Ability of tail end capacitor for power factor correction. Energy meter for monitoring is also looked into for each case. Analysis ki baat karein, analysis of observation on representative LT motor and connection drive is carried out towards following input. Motor load on kilowatt basis and estimated energy consumption. Scope for improving the monitoring system to enable the suitance of regular in-house energy audit function. Scope area of energy conservation with related to cost benefit and source information. The observation are to indicate loading of kilowatt and voltage imbalance in any voltage current frequency power factor machine side condition like load and unload condition. Pressure flow temperature damper throttle operation. Where it is rebound motor, idle operation, metering provision, or etc. Finding and recommendation many include identify motor less than 50% loading, 15 to 75% loading, and 75 to 100% loading over 100% loading. Identified motor with low voltage, power factor, voltage imbalance, and needed improvement measures. Identified motor with machine side losses, inefficient like idle operation, throttling, damper operation. For avenue like automatic control, interlock, variable speed drive. Motor load survey is aimed not only as a measure to identify motor efficiency area but as equally important as a means to check the combined efficiency of motor, driven machine and controller if any. The margin of motor efficiency may be less than 10% is consumption often when the load survey would help to bring out surveying the driven machine system and which will give the 30 to 40% energy saving. These are some questions which is related to this chapter.